Well, it is, of course, the BBC's Sport Relief tonight, and for the first time, it's taking place at the Queen Elizabeth Olympic Park in Stratford. Our sports reporter, Sarah Orchard, is outside the Copper Box in the park to tell us about what's going on. Sarah.
Thank you so much, Asad. Yes, we're live on the Queen Elizabeth Park for the first time that Sport Relief will be broadcast from the Copper Box. You can see most of the audience just making their way in behind me. Most of them are in their seats for the big show that starts at 7 o'clock. I've seen quite a few celebrities so far today. I've seen Little Mix, Claire Balding, also David Walliams, but they're all here for a fantastic cause. And a lot of the projects that benefit from Sport Relief money are right here in the capital. Emma Jones has been to a boxing gym in Hackney.
In many ways, this is like any other school, but when these GCSE students leave the classroom, they head for the boxing ring. Mainstream school hasn't worked for these teenagers. The idea here is to get them to engage in education by about boxing.
It teaches you to work hard, discipline, you know, you will look at any situation, you know, it helps you to face any challenge in life.
Jermaine was in gangs and spent time in prison. His job now to stop others from following in his footsteps. And the academy's tough methods seem to work.
Once you have a punishment, you have to complete that punishment. So I found that because of the punishment, I don't want to be back in that position that I was in before. So I just prefer to get my head down now and really, like, learn what I'm meant to learn so I can just leave here with a good education.
This, of course, all costs money. The Academy, one of more than 1,300 projects in London to benefit from Sport Relief funding. In total, almost £54 million has been given to projects in the capital since 2002. Back in the ring, training continues, and so do the lessons that have seen 9 out of 10 of these pupils go on to further education, training, or a job.
It's given me like a better future, so I can do more with my life and hopefully become a bank owner or manager bank.
An ambition he and so many other young people in London might not have if it wasn't for projects like these. Emma Jones, BBC London News.
Well, one of the crazy things you're going to be seeing this evening on that big Sport Relief programme is going to be called Clash of the Titans. That's where two celebrity teams will be battling it out in various Olympic events across the park, including rhythmic gymnastics and synchronised swimming. And one of the team captains is former double Olympic champion Lord Sebastian Coe. And I caught up with him a little bit earlier over at the Velodrome for a chat of all things Sport Relief, but we did slightly drift onto a football match tomorrow when Chelsea will be playing Arsenal in the Premier League. Lord Coe is a big Blues fan, and tomorrow for him especially is a big game.
I think we will win, but said that, these are two really good footballing sides. I think it'll be a great game. I think there'll be goals. My first Chelsea match was 1967, December. We beat Arsenal 2-1, and I sort of think that might be a bit of a hint for tomorrow.
Lord Coe seeming very confident there. Another bit of Chelsea news. Today they were drawn against Paris Saint-Germain in the quarterfinals of the Champions League. But we do have to talk about Arsenal. It is a special day for Arsene Wenger tomorrow when he will be standing out as manager for the 1,000th